You've gotta fly like an eagle, prowl like a lion in Africa, walk like a panther tonight.
So it seems Walk Like a Panther had already tried to come into the world in the form of a TV series in 2011. I had no idea. But the pilot was never picked up. The writer slash director has come back with his project and made it into a movie. But if the movie was anything like the TV series, I can see why no one wanted to touch it. Walk Like a Panther is one of those many British underdog films following the formula of the likes of The Full Monty, one of my favourite films. So maybe I've been a little bit harsh here, but then again, maybe I am the perfect demographic for the British underdog film. I love them, I lap them up. So some ex-wrestlers from the 80s get back into the ring to save their local pub in West Yorkshire. The film, I'd say, is extremely good timing, you know, with the likes of Glow on Netflix and just the popularity of stories set in the 80s within the film and television industry currently. You know, you've got Stranger Things and etc, etc. 80s is a big deal at the minute. I'm I'm patiently waiting for when the 90s becomes a big thing. But the main problem with Walk Like a Panther is this is a comedy with no laughs. The characters are extremely cartoonish. It just doesn't have that Yorkshire magic. Yes, there is such a thing as Yorkshire magic. I'd like to think you're looking at it right now. It certainly doesn't have that Yorkshire magic of, let's say, Brastov and the Full Monty. And, you know, being a Yorkshire lass myself, I can say I've never met a Yorkshire person like these fools. I know it's a film, but at the same time, it's like, come on, give us a little bit of this I can't even say it. I'm so outraged. Authenticity. You know, Stephen Tomkinson he poured out such a glorious performance in Brastov, but in this he's just embarrassing. It's shocking. It was like watching a bunch of high schoolers act, just going straight for the stereotypes. And I do apologise to those that are out there that are acting in high school, but I know I was once there. I once acted in high school and we went straight for those stereotypes. The writing is pretty poor and that is the main fault with it. You know, the actors did what they can, but at the end of the day, these are written characters and this is what on paper they wanted them to be like. And just the character development is the worst. So the writing itself, the dialogue is pretty poor, but when it comes to the narrative and the character development, it's just pants, because I can't think of a better word right now. You know, the best example would be the Chav, played by Once Upon a Time's Michael Socha. He spends the film being an absolute idiot. You know, you want to give this guy a slap. And all he does is wind up the Panthers. And then all of a sudden, he's just friendly and willing to help. And it's like, where was the point of him realizing that he's been acting like an idiot and he deserves a slap to, I'm gonna help you guys? It made no sense. Got these Rocky-inspired montage sequences and they pick up the film slightly, but it is a missed opportunity to really embrace the Yorkshire surroundings. There are moments where it like has the, you know, climbing up a hill, you know, to emulate the Rocky steps and things like that, but it really didn't latch onto it enough because it really could have brought something funny and inspiring. Because the one thing you need in an underdog formula is a dash of inspiration and just a touch of proudness that the audience can have. And this just delivered none of that. There is a moment towards the end of the film that had actually quite a good chuckle from me, and I couldn't help think, well, why couldn't the whole film be this kind of comedic style? Because that's funny. But the whole film was just it missed its target. I can still remember the Walk Like a Panther song featuring Jarvis Cocker on Top of the Pops in 1999, that's crazy. The fact that I have a memory of him coming on and singing that song in 1999, it's insane. So I really do like that song. And what I found interesting is the film does present a take on Walk Like a Panther. Obviously, why not? Because that's what the film is called. And it's by Rick Astley. And he gives us the sound of Tom Jones. At first I thought it was Tom Jones, but it's actually Rick Astley. And it's actually quite an interesting take. So if anything, the film gave us that. Thanks for watching. Please do like the video. Leave a comment in the box below with your thoughts and feelings on Walk Like a Panther. If you haven't seen it, maybe it's not something that's got over to America yet. Watch the trailer, let me know what you think, thoughts and feelings down below, and please subscribe, hit that notification bell so you never miss a video.